call the meeting to order and do a roll call. And in the region, Nate is here. Carrie is here. Mike is here. Wendy is here. Okay, and we've got a full staff. Mr. Flores and Mr. Craig. Mrs. McLeod and Marcus Rodriguez. So, thanks, Alita Flagstaff. Hand over heart. Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag, one nation, under God, indivisible,
for which stands one nation, under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all. Okay, I know I'm speaking here.
The agenda, meeting of June 8th. That's for that. I got one thing on it, and that is to do the annual report. I guess we need to vote on this.
I'll first.
Second.
Okay. Natalie? Yes? No?
Yes.
You amended it. Second, now you call for a roll call. Then I call for a vote.
What am I doing? They already had first and second. So anyway, Natalie voted yes. Nate?
Yes.
Yes. Carrie? Yes. Mike?
Yes.
Yes. Wendy?
Yes.
Okay. I guess we do have a request from Mr. Entree to address the committee for maximum of 3 minutes.
Oh, is that me? Is that my call? Yes. Hey, maybe, because what's this thing on? It says 20 minutes per subject, and that maximum 20 minutes per subject, that kind of puzzles me.
If the electorate extended to that.
Okay.
Are you starting?
Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, the continuing saga of this bond oversight committee, as recorded on the must-see video, shows the committee members quibbling over $25,000 for a 2006 closing audit as proposed by Mr. Alex Flores, which would be an unmitigated waste of taxpayer dollars when anyone knowing the district's sordid past knows that only a forensic audit will provide the possibility for regaining the lost trust as noted by Mr. Flores. Mr. Ornelas, for the $25,000 audit if it saved X amount of dollars. An audit is an after-the-fact tool which can find waste, fraud, dereliction, and incompetence with the possibility of recovery in some cases. As noted by the $15 million in change orders that the experts stated should have been on the original contract bid, could we have saved $5 million? We note that the recent audit, which finds that the district was 15% over contract and failure to comply with laws governing the Bond Oversight Committee. And we can't forget Mr. Flores once again stating the district's 10% on change orders theory. Questions arise as to how could this independent committee allow Mr. Flores, the bullying by Mr. Flores regarding this annual report coming up that we're reviewing here. This annual report is something that requires consideration and input from all members of this independent committee. Why has the committee, as a team unit, not stood up for the responsibility to the community? Mr. Harry Peterson has done stellar work to bring this committee out of its rubber stamp obscurity. I have called for Mr. Wong to tender his resignation because of the presence of his attendance record and non-contribution to the committee. Nothing personal. Considering the exposure of the Nogales multi-purpose debacle by Mr. Flores once again. Apologies are owed Mr. Peterson and Ms. Wong, or excuse me, Jong, by those who abused them for doing likewise. Emergency funds should be made immediately available for the immediate correction of this albatross. The committee should demand an immediate codification of the candidate selection process as a maximum of 60 days from the receipt of the application. For those who take exception to my critique, just remember, I have offered to this district to never be heard from again or seen again if the district would assume the responsibility of video recording all district meetings and posting them accordingly. Thank you.
Thank you. We don't have to. We don't normally respond to comments in public. But Mr. Wong, personally, I'd like to say that, you know, I'm very happy that you're here. You know, okay. I hope you continue. So, yeah. Okay.
Do you even know some would make you go to the mailbox?
Action items. Review the annual report. So, Natalie and I both worked on things. As a matter of fact, if you look at mine, a lot of stuff that she wrote is in there because.
And then what I had originally sent you was just my very, very first one.
Yeah.
This, in all honesty, is my busiest week of the month. So
yeah.
I got to jot down just here and there.
Yeah.
So, what I gave you here is I added to it.
Yeah, okay, so maybe everybody just needs to take, you know, a few minutes.
Yeah, so we can marry the two together.
And I started off with a meeting summary, that's the last page. And then when I got the stuff from Natalie, I liked the way she did it. And so this is just a worksheet, you know, and like her information flowed better.
Because his meeting summary is what I had thought.
So I've asked staff to be here tonight, but our role is going to be very, just to answer any questions you may have. This is your annual report, so we want to make sure you say that you craft it how you want to. What I can offer is, I believe you emailed this to Josefina today, correct?
Yeah, I did. No, I printed it out.
But you also emailed it. That's how it would be printed out for you?
Yeah.
So I can have a screen come down if you like, and I could forward that email from Josefina to me, to you, to Rosanna, but she can put it onto the screen so you guys can do it together. If you want to craft your report, and it's up there,
yeah.
You can do it live.
I think we should do. Oh, I see what you're saying.
And then this way you have your final product.
Okay.
It's up to you. This way.
That's fine if we can get a final product out of it.
This way you can get a final product out of it, and
yeah.
And time sensitive, we can put it up there.
How do you guys feel?
I'm fine with either way.
Because we're
gonna trim it. I mean, you guys look like it's coming together pretty well. You know what I'm saying? You can see you guys are in the same round, same thought. You know, Harry has a little bit more to put on the paper, but
I have more time.
Yeah.
I'm retired.
I'm just saying. At the end,
yeah.
Hopefully by the end of this, you have a final product. So if you want to put that up on the screen, so as you go through your thing, a final product can be done. So you go walk out with your,
what's going to be presented.
What's going to be presented. This way there's no confusion.
And it'll be presented, what is it, next week?
Tuesday.
So today we've got to have final, right?
Yeah.
If you guys, you know what? Harry and I were interviewing people for the business position before this meeting, and we're just getting a call back, Harry, for that business. Do you want to step back and take it?
Yeah.
Harry and I are going to step back.
You guys can go ahead and talk amongst yourselves.
We still have four people.
Jerry.
Jerry.
And this can be open mic time. Anybody want to come up and say anything? We go from the YouTube site. Grab some cookies on your way in now.
Trump Tower.
would have to make amendments. Changing the bylaws so that you invite more people to apply, because it's been very difficult. A lot of people don't want to deal with coming here every month, and well, every other month. They used to be every month, and then we switched it again to every other month because they felt harassed. By others that aren't on the way. And having negative things put out in the community about them for solely being on this committee. There's many people who have declined just for that, that I approached and spoke with. We agree with some of the people, and that's why they stepped away because they're going to come back. They're interviewing. She'll pull up mine, and she'll pull it up on this, and we can kind of put on the
computer. No, actually, I think we should have set them all on first. Okay. So we only need more content. I mean, no content, we can put on the community. So which parts first, and just fill in the online. We should set it all on first.
Well, that's not how I'm going to do it.
No. Well,
you have a DVD. You have the outline. We're doing this now.
No, we do,
no,
right?
No,
it's good. You also have to do online every.
Okay.
So
I tried breaking
to
that
piece
a little
piece
bit.
Mm-hmm.
I did try doing that, but okay.
No, like you mentioned,
what we did.
Even on some screen. Recommendation, what we need, right? So that we show that member, so that we have for the one not even category.
Yeah. I have emailed me your draft. Okay.
Which one? Today's draft?
I hope
it was today's draft. I hope I
if I do, that time is not getting paid by my
dollars.
There are no secrets.
Carrie, when do you want to come up with an outline?
No, we could just merge them both. She was saying, hey, we'll get the outline, we'll throw in the bullet points, and then you can just fill it in as we go, right?
Right.
Wait, we have to present it on the 16th. Is that right?
13.
It's okay. No, both of you, the guys.
She wants to do it today, right? Like, wait,
are we want to get a final at least we have online, so
yes.
Let us question,
yes.
So at the building get a report, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
No, I mean, look at the Bosov report, you know, it's good. Look like Natalie was like activity. He summarized the activity what we've done in the past year. Right? Did you see her report?
I didn't get a chance to read the whole thing. No.
Uh-huh.
I couldn't quite hear you or...
Okay, so based on the results of your draft, we come out like outline our
uh-huh.
report.
Uh-huh.
So we just put them together or add something. So at least we have some outline for today's report.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe take some
time. So, you know, if you want to use one or the other and it's a duplicate, you want to line it out on one of them. So it's not, I don't know how you want to do that. But
no, we just have outline first.
Yeah. Okay.
Based on yours.
Okay.
Because
okay.
Natalie put up pretty much is like activity. He summarized what we've done in past year.
Okay.
The activity.
Okay. Okay.
So we based on yours, we
okay.
can just summarize the outline, we can add or, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, you
emailed it to me. Does anybody have any problem with the second paragraph where I said that there were a lot of credits?
Plug me in.
My battery was dead.
Would you have it this black?
Oh, no, the third paragraph where I say at the conclusion, you know, they had all the reviews and then nothing happened. So that's kind of a. You know, I'm being a little bit mean there, I did make some recommendations, and we went another year with, you know, I stressed the fact that we needed to have 7 members. I stressed that. And then we went another year, and we still only had 6 members. So, you know, I thought it was appropriate to.
I suggest, you know, we know we short a member, so probably we can use one paragraph mention. So we according to bylaw, we need 7 members, but we short two members. So we just use separate paragraph.
Yeah.
We don't want to repeat all the.
Oh, true.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, the thing is, this, you have it at the conclusions again. You have it in the beginning,
okay.
You have it in the conclusion,
okay.
And then you actually state it in conclusions, not just in one paragraph, you state it in 2 paragraphs, so
okay.
It's kind of,
okay.
I would say, okay, you know what, let's just put it in one spot, you know,
actually,
I would say, hey, at this time, the district is
actually, it could be a new point tomorrow.
Yeah.
We're in there interviewing people.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah,
but just
have,
at this
yeah.
time, we're not. It's nothing that we haven't not
but
press, try to press forward with. It's just
yeah.
I'm trying to get like trying to get a horse to drink water. The horse doesn't want to drink when they're drinking. If someone doesn't want to be a member, we can't force anybody to come in. This is all voluntary on a voluntary basis. So
no, this is a
we can probably put some suggestion. We can put
I've talked to many people.
Ooh.
They don't want to be followed.
I didn't see any evidence of any, it's on the internet, and I didn't see any evidence of any other effort to correct the problem.
I've talked to people, have you gone to different meetings and invited people?
I was never aware of that. They made me aware of anything that was being done.
But have you gone out to look?
Gone out to look.
To invite people to
yes,
watch, and how many of the people you invited chose to apply?
Only 3 or 4 people that I know.
Natalie, so you guys can start working on it.
Oh, okay.
And this is not by me.
And gross.
This is
not
by this. So, you know, I would rather not, you know, be attacked.
I'm not trying to attack you. Okay.
Conversion.
Delete and type.
Oh, man.
so.
Okay, folks, I'm here to help in whatever capacity you would like. Alex has given me a...
an assignment?
No, you can't give me an assignment.
No, he says help.
He gave me a request to help. And so this is the this is the draft that was provided via email. I don't know whether I think everyone's got a copy of it. Is this the, and if this is what you'd like, I'm happy to help edit as we go through. And if there's areas that people want to change or things like that, I'm happy to help.
We're going to try to marry it.
That's why I suggest we do online first, and based on the online, put them together, add something, maybe something.
So is Dennis making a blank page for us to work on, or are we going to use this as the outline and just add carry stuff into it? Or take stuff that's already there out?
Okay.
I said just get it online, but we can use the content here.
Yes, we can use the content. But I understand what you're saying.
So that way, okay.
Yeah,
I'm happy to copy paste. I'm happy to do whatever you like.
Yeah. We're starting with the blank page.
And Alex is going to owe me for this.
Give him some cookies.
I don't need a cookie.
Mr. Bixel, can we have a blank page, please?
You have a blank page.
Okay.
And I type slowly, so that's a warning.
So you want to type 2017 CBOC annual report.
Okay, done.
Usually, the first report we type like a summary, right? We type a summary, so you just short introduction about the.
I like Harry's work, he just gives the list of names. Members?
Yeah, I like that, but I think we should remove the. Not remove it, but the third paragraph. Say at this time. We're all currently committee members.
So you want committee members?
No, I want to leave it in there, but I think we need to
reword it a little better.
I cut it down. Yeah.
Okay.
Not I don't want it to be so harsh. I would say.
Okay.
I don't want to give up anything. I just want it to be a little smoother.
Well, let's how about if we strike out and nothing happens? Because that's very.
That helped a great deal.
Should that be part of the conclusion? Opposed to the opening?
Yeah, it should be the conclusion, but we should say at this time we already have five members on the BOC.
Just seven. Who's the members?
And then state all the members. Like Harry has it, what
do you like it broken down like Harry's on here?
Yeah, for I would want to
representing the seniors, boom.
Yeah, boom. I would just bullet it, one space it, and he has that down pretty well. Harry's okay. That's
and if anybody has any questions or wants to make a suggestion, just yell it out.
Well, the first, we want the two first paragraphs of Harry's report in there.
Okay.
I think that's, does anybody object to that?
Yeah, I don't. No, I just said, you know, this, how did we inform? That's based on the Proposition 13, right? So the CBOC committee, according to Proposition, just short introduction, how is it informed?
Yeah, I don't like the first paragraph.
And who are the member?
Well, I like saying that, you know.
That was proper, you know?
Yeah.
I gave a report, I did not say whether or not the district was in compliance.
But I don't think last year's report should be referenced in this year's report. This year's report is about this year, not about last year.
So something started off during the 2017?
I really didn't want to talk too much because it's your report. But I just want to help facilitate, if that's okay with the member, that I don't want to think I'm asking to say anything. Is that okay, Mr. Chair?
Sure.
Okay. I think what Wendy's saying that there should be some sort of body to begin. And if I could suggest taking a look at the bylaw, it says committee establishment. Maybe that paragraph of the committee establishment would be cut and paste, where it says the Rolling Unified School District with a successful election. Oh, just so it's like it's...
An introduction.
An induction. I think that's what Wendy is saying.
Yeah.
So if it's okay with you, Mr. Fixer, I will send you the bylaw so you can cut and paste it so you have to do all the typing.
This report is to the public, and a lot of them don't, they don't know what Proposition 39 is, or major honor, they don't know what, you know, what we're all about, but it should be some kind of introduction to them to tell them, you know, what...
Absolutely.
You know, who we are and what we're doing.
So we could actually go online and get those, because they're posted online too, since our webpage has all of CBOC information. But honestly, I send it to you guys. As a matter of fact, that might be helpful too, because I think in the bylaw itself it says what criteria you want for the annual report to make it more simple. Maybe someone's going to you right now, Mr. Wexler. Let's see if I can find out.
In what font you said? I have a copy.
Okay.
Let me ask a question here, Eric. So I get exactly what you want. If you take a look at the screen, on Mr. Peterson's piece, there was right below co-chair Wendy's song, also from PTA and parent was left blank. Is there something?
Okay. Is there something supposed to be there?
Oh, those are two of them.
That
we're trying to do?
Sean.
Your name.
It's not there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I'm
sorry, Natalie.
I had it backwards and I was redoing it.
It's okay.
It should be Natalie. Sorry.
Not at all.
Yeah.
So it's not there.
And so I think, am I correct in hearing that someone said... Am I correct in hearing that somebody had asked that we recognize that there were two unfilled positions?
Yes, I do like that.
Yeah, you just read it.
Except it might be a new point by the time I get to it.
No, because you're going to be presenting, the board still has to vote on new members, so.
That's true.
Okay. Well, can I add something?
Does this work for you? As of June.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah.
We're going to take this new name to the next board meeting.
Yeah, okay.
So.
And Alex, did you send me the next piece?
I sent you the piece right on top of that.
Yeah.
Which is the first paragraph.
Okay. Did you hit
the link? Aren't you happy you walked in today? I'm glad we're a friendly group.
So you want, I thought you'd send me the finished version.
That's what I'm saying. I said I don't have it, but it's on the website. Let me see, do you have that?
It's fine. So you want this paragraph?
The finished one.
I think that's the paragraph that...
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Without the section one.
That should be on top. That intro.
That goes on top.
You want that above the committee membership?
Yes.
Okay. You got it.
He got it.
I give it to him. I give it to him. Terry had a copy.
So November 6, 2012.
Actually, you know, can you do me a favor, Dennis? Could you go to, this would be easier for you. So you know, can you go to section 610, committee reports, just so we can show what the board has approved as the bylaws of what the annual report should consist of? This way they help give guidance, maybe.
610, you said?
610, please. Because I just. So if you go down, look, yeah, there you go. So you go back down so you can get the top so that you know that this is about the end. Let's go up the other way. Go up. Go up. There you go. That's the second one. Go down. So you get that. That's. If you want to take the time to. One and two are part of the committee.
Sorry, guys.
So that's the annual report. If you guys want to read that, the committee shall prepare the reports, activities, and then what should be in the annual report. And if we need to go to Article 13A, Section 1B3, to know what the requirements are, we can do that for you too.
Would you like me to include this?
Money on administration salaries.
Mm-hmm.
Would the committee like me to include this purpose statement on the report?
Yeah. No.
Because he's going to be reading the report.
Well, that's true.
Yeah, but.
But this is for public, you know, because we have to post.
So the board agenda is going to be to present and to receive the annual report.
Uh-huh.
So the written copy will be presented to the board, and also Harry or whoever would like to do it.
Is going to read it.
Yeah.
Is he going to read every word of it, or is it highlights?
That's for the committee to decide. I'm not gonna.
Are you going to read everything that we put in the report to the board, or did you want to just do the highlights?
Well, we decide that later, after we see what we got.
Okay. Yeah.
So for now, put it in.
Yeah.
We can always.
Yeah, always.
This is a group vote of the day. At the end of the day, it's not one person's report, it's a committee report. So you five can vote, majority be three.
Something along these lines, and I'm happy to change it.
It is report post on the website?
We'll post it on the website too. We want to be as transparent as possible.
All right, I think we could reword that a little bit so it isn't, we're not, you know, reading word for word what the Constitution says, but, you know, the committee prepares regular reports on its activities instead of shall. A report.
Well, you're going to, when you go in front of the committee, you could say, hey, you know what, one of the things we're supposed to, a requirement of ours is to ensure that we're compliant with Article, you know, blah, 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 section this, and did we meet that? Yes, we did, or no, we didn't, you know.
Let me try
to leave that there.
Let me try getting both of your concepts in here.
I can't see it back here.
Actually, we have to base on this, so how online? Why do I
have
to post?
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Yeah, why do I have to post all in there? We base on this for our online. We need an activity. We have to ensure compliance. So our conclusion will be, is the district compliant?
Correct.
Yeah, There's no need to copy all of them.
Harry, does this meet with what you were, I think you were trying to get kind of an introductory statement?
Yes.
So pursuant to the bylaws of the CBOC, the committee is charged with the responsibility to prepare reports on its activities. And then that's kind of the introductory statement to what's going on.
Right.
I just think that.
Yeah,
when you
bring in committee stuff,
No. I think just going back to what Wendy is saying, that at the end of the day, this is what your report's supposed to be. Did you or did you not?
Mm-hmm.
Right. You know, and it's a yes or no answer. And then the number two is your activities. So talking about what do we do in our meetings and things like that. I think, Natalie, you summarized that in your thing pretty well.
Yes.
And Harry, too.
Uh-huh.
So if you don't got it.
Okay. So if we were high school students and we had a two-page essay to write, we're halfway done.
Well, if you double space, we're almost.
Or you can be like,
no, I don't think we are.
Bonds.
No, if you really want the purpose of the annual report, we can summarize them just like paragraph. So what's the purpose of this report? But not copy each word, just summarize.
So just I the agree. First sentence. This is your report. I'm just.
Just the first sentence.
It's your report, whatever you guys like.
Whatever you want.
We're just here to assist.
What I'm hearing is maybe this portion that I've just highlighted
exactly gone.
May not be necessary.
Yeah, gone. Because we're going to have part one, point one and point two.
Would you like me to take this out?
Yes.
The highlighted section.
Yeah, take off.
Harry can't see.
Yeah, please, do a little bit. Okay.
Done. Does that help a little bit for you?
Oh, you can see over there. Huh? Wow, you got good eyes.
Okay, folks. It's 8 o'clock.
The screen over there.
The alarms will be set at 11, so we've got work to do.
Yes, we got work to do.
But don't feel rushed if you can't get it done. We just won't have it. It's okay. Do your thing.
We'll just have Dennis come back.
Jim,
we'll
literally only see
Ain't it all deviate or able tonight?
Like this direction?
Go down.
Okay.
I have trouble driving at night.
That's the blank page that I started with.
No, that's only two, right?
Yeah, you can add more pages.
No, yeah, I can add as much as you'd like.
If it's on all bylaw, that's only two, right?
Yeah, that's all that I. This is all that I've taken so far.
Okay, then just summarize, copy them all.
So now if you take a look at maybe at some of the activities that Natalie's outlined or Harry's outlined, you can kind of paste those activities as activities. You just label activities, and then whoever goes, you can list the activities.
I think, we just mentioned what's a bond. So this we cover 2016 bond or no?
2006
and 2012.
Yeah, so probably you haven't. Because this is for public, so public they have no clue about this. That's why I suggest we put we have some short cover like what's 2006 R bond.
That's in the first paragraph. I think it says it, right?
It
did. Yes, it's. Oh, maybe I didn't go up.
How much amount? They didn't tell you how much amount.
100.
Yeah, 118 million.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, that's covered.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
That's good enough. Yeah.
No, that was your idea. That's what we're interested in. I don't know if we need to have committee establishment, but that's your, whatever you got.
Okay. That's another one. I would change the District Board of Education. Hereby, I would, that they, I'm saying.
We don't have that in there. We could just
that's
take it out.
That shouldn't be there.
Take it out.
That's just up there.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that has nothing to do with our annual report.
No.
That's
because you're lifting something from the bylaws.
Yeah.
This is your report, not the
okay.
board. It's presented to the board.
Scroll down.
Do I have all the members? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I think it would look nice if that was centered, though.
What? I just make a single space bulleted, boom.
There's two bullets.
We say what the 200 fill positions are.
Okay, that's okay. Just
that we have two, so we're short.
Yeah.
We
We know we're short. We're working on being short.
Sorry, we're working on being taller. So we got the purpose now. I'm hearing the next section is going to be the activities.
Activities. So we can use Natalie.
So go scroll down to mine.
Is this correct? Activities at CBOC in 2016-17?
Correct.
Okay.
Chop the first part. That one right there. First little paragraph. Needs to go completely. Has no use.
Okay. No use?
No use.
Why is this thing not letting me catch it? Alex, what did you send me? Did you send me something that's damaged?
I don't know. It's not a PDF.
That's Word.
No, but is it an image?
Oh.
What do you mean an image?
Something's leaking in the file.
Because it's in compatibility mode. File, save as, change the name, open it back up.
Use mine and add in what Natalie is.
Yeah, that's what he's trying to do, is just cut it and paste it, and then we can add in the other stuff that you put in yours.
Oh, okay.
Now that we have a really awesome heading.
Okay, here we go. Now we're cooking with Word.
Okay,
so I'm going to
email this to myself.
And
yay!
So good.
Good.
Delete that?
Delete.
Done.
Where there's a parentheses, I was a loss for words. Next, to supervise, observe, look at, watch.
And we'll continue to monitor?
Okay. Well, not just Roland, always what's going to be starting.
So throughout the district? Do I hear throughout the district?
Throughout the district. Oh, but you know, sorry. That sentence, that activity was specific to Nogales. We haven't been back to Nogales since for the grand opening.
Okay. Can I be respectful to my construction? He had an early appointment tomorrow with regarding some issues at Roland, positive issues. Is there any questions that you feel you need to ask Marco regarding construction, regarding to make sure that the district was compliant in every aspect that we needed to be compliant? If not, I would like to excuse him. Is there any question that you may have that we needed for the report?
No.
I can't take that.
Yeah.
He has a very good.
I really appreciate you being there because we did.
At any time throughout the evening, we may still call you, Mr. We want you to make sure you
have access to your cell phone, out of your phone
so that you're
saying.
Ready and don't pull the same thing you pulled me last week and we had to sit your phone with it.
So actually, pass it to Alex so you can see the battery.
I don't see your charger.
Oh,
yeah,
it is.
Okay. So go ahead and plug it into your charger.
You didn't want me to buy it.
Marcos?
So it is empty.
Can you check the spelling on the names of these contractors?
Yeah, it's with an E. That's correct. That's what Myers. That's correct.
M-E-Y-E-R?
This is correct.
M-E-Y-E-R?
Not it.
Okay.
Yeah. And Ziemba
is correct.
Where it says the G-M-G-O-M?
Oh, I didn't know what to call him, so So I put GSM for general contract manager.
Just
I don't think the public's going to know what that is. I don't know what that is.
Contract manager?
CM.
You can put construction manager. And then afterwards put CM, parentheses, this way the meeting will know in the future.
Bear with me, I was typing this up in 3 minute intervals. Or less.
And that is going to have the beast button Myers?
That's right, because they can call you as working, and you can claim the full time.
But on that paragraph, can we see you're talking about Roland High School?
This one, yeah, this paragraph, I was specifically talking about Roland Heights, Roland High School. I did want to try to bring up that we do know that there were overrun, there were change orders with Nogales. But I know that you've missed Alex and the construction manager at Roland. They're really going over and nitpicking the plans, and the construction company is constantly coming to us to let us know that the updates they've made. What, 15,000 changes?
Yeah, 15,000 changes.
15,000 changes to the plans before it goes to the state architecture, so that way when they come back, it's going to, well, obviously, all plans are supposed to be built the way that they go come back.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
This way, it will help reduce, for this project, learning from the last project, the change orders.
So where are we with? So going back to Mike's point, though, we have originally met with the construction manager, CM, for the Roland addition project from Odetha Meyer. Do you want that in there to
yes.
signify that's for Roland?
That's Roland.
Is that just
your project?
One, is that what you're
yeah, yeah, I mean, we're right here and just
making reference to it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is our activity is on from the past year, current or current past?
What do you mean? This past year, we've done all of this past year.
Are you based on the order? Based on time order?
Is it in chronological order?
Timeline. There's some playroom. Because the Oswalt project and the Dallas project was last. With the stakeholder that with the stakeholder meeting at Oswalt, Nogales was the very first. Most of the bulk of what we've been dealing with is Roland.
And it's kind of hard too because the committee has asked for every board meeting to have an update. So it's
on almost, everything.
So it's almost kind of going out through. It's happened repeatedly throughout the whole year.
Correct.
That's an outside.
Can't.
I'm happy to take
okay.
direction.
Scroll.
Scroll up.
Take out where?
The G and the C and the third line.
See if I can get there before you.
Got it.
That top statement there, the accountant's advisor on the right of South of Board Oversight's input on the 1561 audit. Actually, they interviewed me.
So you want to put by interviewing chair?
I think it's it might be a required process. As a matter of fact, one of the he kept asking me the same question over and over.
Well, I put instead of it saying meeting, how about interview? Because it's fair.
Yeah,
yeah. Interviewing the committee chair?
Yes. Yeah.
I don't know if it's a proper place.
I got it.
I don't know if it's a proper place to put it, but during the interview process, I asked him if the audits that he does, if he audits to the Culver report, does he see the same information that we see? And the answer was no. Then he audits to some other program that the district is required to government. I don't even know what it was exactly. So, but they didn't audit to the same thing that we said. I asked them for a copy. They're supposed to have a written plan of what they're doing. I asked them for a copy of that, and I didn't get it. So I don't know that we need to put that.
When was this?
Pardon?
When was this?
It's a year ago.
During this year? A year ago?
Right, in the
yes.
Audit. Somebody mentioned at the last meeting that the audits, I guess, are being done right now. That they are or will be done or something. Matter of fact, I think that's why we're here, because there is an audit being done, and the auditor needs to check it off his list that we've done this. I forgot where I was going with this. I'm just letting you know. And there's some people, and in fact, I noticed Natalie, you know, whispering to Matt, Nate, last meeting, you know, that I was interviewed. She didn't know. I tried to put it on a list one time of things, but there were so many on there that it didn't make it. I guess it wasn't that important to let everybody know that they were doing an interview, but it's part of their process.
No, last time you were mad because they didn't seek any input and you were interviewed, is what I was saying.
Yeah. I don't know where you got that.
I think you said at the meeting.
You said in the meeting you were upset that the auditor didn't ask us what we wanted for the audit or any questions, and you were interviewed by them.
I think
that's why I was.
I don't know. They're mixing apples and oranges there somewhere. One has nothing to do with the other. Yeah.
Well, I think it was your statement. I think your statement was that the auditor didn't speak to anyone, and that was confusing because...
Okay, we just saw the auditor here. My concern, if I said that, was my concern was we just talked to the auditor here a month or two ago. Okay. He was at there. He was presenting the audit from last year. We didn't, you know, nobody told us, okay, there's an audit going on now. Would you like to ask some questions about...
But
this
hasn't started yet.
I don't know. We're not. We're never.
Oh, sorry.
ABO.
That's cool.
ABO, the Canadian. LEDGE ABO.
The E?
GE.
I can't hear you. I need David's hearing aid.
I'm tired.
You're freaking tired.
Thank you.
So
why
are
you with
us?
I
think
you should be
able
to brighten us.
Oh.
Okay, thank you. God.
I mean,
sorry, it wasn't. No.
I'm just confused. more than what? Previous or something?
May I say?
How about the committee just gaining more,
yeah,
more knowledge and experience?
Now that would have been easier.
No, let me say a committee member will continue being trained and working.
Okay.
Knowledge
and experience. How about through continued? Involvement and further training.
Very good. Good enough.
Is that the gist of what you're trying to get?
That's the gist. It was painful.
I'm sorry. It's been a fun. It's all right.
You're killing me, Smalls.
I was supposed to be home asleep right now.
Okay, hold on.
Recommendation. Yes. For the stretch.
Mr. Mountain, are you going to order pizza?
So, what's next? Recommendation?
Yeah.
Okay, talk about the member. We need them. So, according to bylaw, we need a seven, right? Just as according to bylaw, we need a seven, we still strong two. So, we suggest what?
I don't know if chair, the chairman wants to share right now our recommendation we'll be saying to the board. Mr. Chairman, do you want to say anything about the interview we conducted?
Like the timeline that they were talking about before, you know, it's up to what has happened to now, you know, and you know, if we bring somebody on board by the we can't say in our report whether or not.
Absolutely no. I'm just saying that we had successful.
We can share that information.
We had successful conversations that we that the chair feels comfortable recommending to me to put on the board agenda to recommend to the board to select or to have the two final positions filled.
We want to put at this time then.
Yeah, look, I think it represents that we haven't. I think I want to credit again the committee here who changed the bylaws to allow for that business owner to not have to live within, because that's the same person who wanted to be in it last year is still and came to meetings. He continued and he actually reapplied to be part of the committee, and so we're really fortunate that the person, you know.
Is that an activity that I hear that was not, because the change in the bylaws is not included as an activity?
Oh, that's true.
I thought it was. It was part, I wrote it in with the recommendation.
Yeah, that was something you guys did, so.
Yeah. So we need to cut that one. And
Dennis,
Alex wanted you to type this all up on here.
And
just
I would have told
take
him.
Take out the first sentence. The copy of the bylaw, the same committee needs 7 people.
That's great, but then cut the other piece as an activity, is what you're saying, right?
Put the
bylaws as an activity, recommendation.
You guys enhanced your bylaws.
Yeah.
We didn't think that is an activity.
That was a long
the recommendations we have some of those.
Where would you like to add that in?
Put it at the end.
Before the training?
Yeah, before the training.
But it was kind of continual.
Yeah. All year.
Yeah.
It was 2 years.
All right.
Do you want to say as a result, there's going to be a recommendation of to fill the two vacant spots?
Actually, we do that.
Yes,
right now, right?
Because of that track and change that would work nicely.
Is that an accurate statement?
Absolutely.
Yes. The point is we know. We've been working on it, and now we might be at the end of the tunnel on this stuff.
When will you be making that recommendation, Mr. Flores?
So we had successful, the chair had successful conversations with the individual, so we're hoping for this board meeting, so actually the reports may be done, and then later in the board agenda, the board will give an opportunity to approve the recommendation.
So June 13th.
Yes.
This will provide for a full CBFC?
Yes.
Well, we can fill in the position already, right?
No,
we're going.
This
should be on the. So, why do we recommendation?
Don't
you recommend the feeling already?
We can only recommend. The board is the one who.
Uh-huh.
So, as a result of the recent amendment to the bylaws.
Approved by you, I'm not necessarily addressing only the board. This report is to the public.
Yeah, I 100% agree with you, and approved by the board, because this is. This is a community annual report.
As a result of the recent amendment to the bylaws, recruitment and interviews have been held. Recruitment activities have taken place. Interviews, it feels like there, it feels to me, just as I'm reading it from the outside, that it's missing something.
I guess if we've acknowledged the fact that it's taken place, that we can say that, I guess.
It's taken place, and recommendations are filled.
Is this accurate?
It's on the recommendation.
Hold on, we have to.
No, I thought we should move this to the recommendation.
Yeah.
Because it's not left yet.
Yeah, but it's already passed. This is already the past. This happened today, so it's still a part of activities, wouldn't it be?
Yeah.
So it can't be recommendation because we've already
done it. It's happened by the time the.
You get a new recruitment, today's what?
I think.
Today's the 8th.
Not passed yet, it's June 13th.
Yes, but we have two people who've been interviewed.
But this topic, this should be on the recommendation because we shot two states.
No, we'll roll it back down under the recommend that we recommend that the board approve them.
I know, but this should be on the recommendation, you know?
But this is the whole reason why we changed our bylaws was to open it up.
That's right, so that's why the recommendation was shot two, so that's what we recommend.
So maybe give me in two different places if I can interject. There, as you want it, but then if you want to, under recommendations, that the recommendation would be that
to maintain a full CVOC.
Yeah, to maintain a full CVOC and to find different avenues to recruit or to advertise vacancies. That's a recommendation because
could have vacancies in the future, people.
Yeah.
Turn out or are no longer qualified or just decide to leave.
Like, for example, we just started using Twitter, and we flew out Twitter to have people say if they're interested in being part of the CVOC. We just did that a few weeks ago. I don't know, with this application that we got in, maybe that was a tweet that the person saw. So,
how did they find us?
Yeah, that's.
Well, I've been right in my mouth for months. I even tell them about Harry's cookies.
I think the concern is that it was a long time. We all have the same concern that it went a long time. I think the business owner, I think with the CBOC's action to change the bylaws, I think that was the recommendation to the board will help that. But still, I guess the last one hasn't been gone too long.
So I really, I guess you're right.
It's the business owner that's gone for a whole year. And that's because of the bylaws.
2 years.
Is it 2 years?
Yes.
No.
Really? We haven't had it. That's why it was in the.
That's right. That was the construction guy, huh? Yeah, that was like a year and a half, yeah.
Yeah.
Like 3 months, yeah. 2 school years, you're right. 2 school years.
Yeah.
Not 2 calendar, 2 school years.
That's why I put it in the beginning, you know, the advised. Well, I guess that part was taken out. But I advised the board that we need to get that problem corrected, and here we are again, and it still hasn't been corrected.
Well, the good thing to know is after you guys worked on the CVOC bylaws and they were changing, the board approved them, a month later, we got a fill. So I think that's the action, and I think that really shows you that that's been addressed.
Can I push, have you guys push the pause button for just a minute?
Uh-huh.
So as I've been listening,
it's right there.
This was the paragraph that we were working on. CPOC have debated and worked with staff to update committee bylaws to help assist in recruiting other members. These new bylaws were recently approved by the board. As a result of the recent amendments to the bylaws, recruitment occurred, interviews have been held, and a recommendation to fill the two vacant positions will be presented to the board on June 13, 2013. This will provide for a full CBOC. Is this, hearing your conversation, I think that I heard that there was interest in having this included like this as an activity.
Yes.
Because it is an activity.
Okay. And then I also heard under recommendations.
Just so that in the future, we try to use all kind of multimedia to.
So let's see if I've captured what you're looking for. Number one, approve the recommendation of the two new candidates for the vacant positions on the CBOC at the June 13 governing board meeting.
Okay.
And then maintain a full complement of members on the CBOC with expanded recruitment efforts to include social media, personal contacts, and other means.
Very good.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you want, right?
With that in mind,
Dennis, do you have a copy of
Harry's?
He brought copies today.
Yeah.
What did you mention that?
Show me, Harry, what you want included, and I'll type it. Show me what it is that you want me to include.
Do you have a copy?
I have a copy, but I don't know what you want it specifically.
Under recommendation.
Okay.
You're talking about right here.
You're right, right.
So Harry wants to be informed when the audit starts.
Okay, under recommendation.
This page? Not for your personal.
Okay.
So you guys want.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay, I'm also asking that we get reports. I like to call it a report. When we come to a meeting, but there are a lot of these reports are done monthly, but they're not put on the website, and we don't see them monthly. We only see them when we come to the meeting, and it's a short time to review it.
The last three paragraphs that you have right there.
You make a recommendation
well,
as
the
report.
The last one
on the website.
I'm going to the third paragraph. Okay. We recommend that all construction and financial reports about bond issues be published on the Bond Oversight Committee's website on a monthly basis or as soon as they become available to the district, as opposed to 72 hours before the next meeting. Boy, that would be a big help to me.
Well, we just...
Well, you're saying to be... So it would be transparent, everybody would know, it'd be there, would you look at it when...
So you're asking for our staff to produce things that we don't produce. I have no problem producing and putting anything that we bring to a meeting, but if you're asking for my staff, then the CBOC budget doesn't. If I need to hire somebody, I mean, and for this, and that's what you're saying that you want. I mean, my staff is limited in what they can do, so. If you're saying that you want more reports and more things, I just help me understand that so I can understand. If there's, I know at the last meeting there was concern about having the reports, the presentations that the contractors give, architects give, sooner. Sometimes they even bring them. So I've already spoken to them, so told them I wanted a week in advance of the meeting so I could send it to you guys. So.
that's fine. But if you want other reports created, we're here to help. We're here to give you whatever you want to do. But just let us know, because I have a limited staff and I have to make adjustments too.
Yeah, but did you make a monthly report each month?
We can.
It's not asking for anything that you're not producing already.
Yeah, but see, that's the way I think he's saying that. I don't think we do a monthly report on that, do we? Mr. Harrison, Harrison said that. So do you do a monthly thing on the Colby, or do you do it for the CBOC meeting every 2 months?
We do it for the CBOC meeting.
Okay, so every 2 months we do it. So.
Yeah, I mean, I don't do it every month. I mean,
yeah. Why make us do it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
That was the question I had. Yeah. So what you're saying though is every report that we do for the CBOC should be up on the website, which I think we're doing, aren't we not?
But he wants it up before the meeting.
Oh, okay, okay.
And before, what, a week, Harry?
Say that?
A week? Would you like to have the reporting about a week?
That would be helpful.
Okay.
So, as a CBOC, I just wanted to make sure, do you want that out on the website the week before, or do you want it to be sent to you with your agenda in a week in advance? I'm asking you that. I'm asking you as a whole committee, because this is a whole committee decision. So,
I think, and this is just my opinion, I think it should be sent to us. That way we can review it, we can get our questions out, and then after we've already reviewed it and we've discussed it or something, whatever's, then we can make it transparent to the public.
That typically is the protocol, but I just want to be, I want to be your servant.
Yeah. But I don't think we are receiving it personally.
That's true. And that's a note that we made to give to you a week in advance.
Right.
So from this point forward, that's a recommendation would be, I think a week before the CBOC meeting, CBOC members will receive all handouts
that will be
shared.
What do you think?
That would be an improvement. That's for sure, yeah.
Okay. And then we post that the following meeting after the board has after you guys have approved the minutes.
Right.
Okay.
So there is a delay, but
yeah, there is a delay,
it does get.
What about the concept of advising committee of any major problems that they're having at the Nogales site, that you know one of the buildings is sinking or something like that.
Instead of seeing the change order, noticing it when a change order comes, you want to know what's happening.
Yeah.
So
is that what you said?
Yeah. Well, that's one of them. Yeah. Instead of after it's already done.
So there's a commitment that we said that you guys wanted, when for every meeting, for us to have the architects and have the construction managers give you an update on the project, which we've been doing. During that time, that would be probably something that they would be updating and sharing with you.
So that wasn't going on during the Nogales?
No.
The Nogales project is so many years ago.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Unfortunately, everyone brings it up like it was yesterday, but people are.
I hear you.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to establish a case and say, hey,
I got
you.
So.
That wasn't there. This is now. I think that works out pretty well. I think we're covering ourselves as a committee, and we're trying. And what I'm being told right now at this time and moment is that we're up to date on everything.
Now, you're up to date up to the point, and between this point and next point, if anything happens, I mean, there's like a 2 month in between.
Yeah.
So, the thing is, with my concern, I don't know if this is what you're asking for, Harry, is to be told about a work order before. You're in the process. You could probably explain it better than me, in that if you were to wait 2 months for a change work order thing to be, what would happen?
Well, time. Money, materials, that all cost, that they all affect each other. So if I need to finish a project, I have deadlines I need to meet. I have things I have to.
You know. Not approve them. I'm not asking to be approved.
But that's what I'm asking.
No, no. He's saying we might not know about it until 2 months after the fact, due to the fact that there's a 2 month spread in between right. each meeting. So okay. I would take action at that moment, and then yes, of course, I would be transparent and show all that happens. Everybody knows that nothing goes according to plan. Every project has its issues.
Right.
And I do expect to hear those issues come up and see what's going on.
So with the improved activity that we did this year of having, based upon the recommendations of the CBOC members, of having every CBOC meeting have an update with the projects in motion, that's taking care of that concern. Maybe that should be part of an activity too.
Yeah, you should add it.
Because that actually is something we did differently this year that you got based upon you guys saying it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
as I
you guys are a good group. You guys have done a lot of good things.
Let them know we've done something. Right?
Yeah, we
yeah, you guys have done a lot of good stuff.
We are
stuff.
Not people like you just said, we are FOB.
So am I hearing that the agenda for regular meetings have been altered from past?
Yeah,
from past committees, long committees, to include monthly updates.
I didn't know that was a standardized thing that the architects come into us.
The standardized thing, Harry, is to have one meeting per year.
But I think what
that's
happened.
Standardized thing.
I think there was a meeting last year. I wasn't there.
Tell me
when you were running it, and it went kind of sideways with
I thought
like,
we
too much was
that
on the agenda. So I think that's when the you guys decided
sorry,
to have that.
Wasn't that?
This is just
okay, scroll down. I thought that was messy. Look at various phase planning, construction updates, and budgetary matters. Updates in construction and planning, so that potential issues that could arise could be dealt with before they became a financial burden. It's already in there.
It's in there, but it doesn't call out that this paragraph doesn't call out that that's a change from the past.
Uh-huh. So I think the difference is
instead of reinventing the wheel, let's figure out how to include that in that paragraph.
Or it can be separate thing. Uh-huh. Because it's two different things. But they don't talk about change order when they talk about an update on the project. And we want your major roles and responsibilities to know how things are going in the project.
I'm trying to understand what Harry wants. He wants to know what's the problem on each job where we meet. Is that what you're kind of asking?
We should be kept advised of what's going on with the project. In fact, you know, they say, oh, we built this, and the money's been spent. Well, that's good. We know all of that. But certainly know if there's problems or setbacks.
Do you feel that?
Let me give you an example. I mean, we have problems on our jobs.
Yeah. Major. I don't need
major. I mean, the general contractor notifies the owner when they call out a knock and notice a change. Mm-hmm. We'll get that. It'll be a 2-3 weeks. Mm-hmm. I mean, and then, you know, with engineers and all that, we'll get the notice of a change. Then they'll go to the subcontractors for pricing. That's another month.
Yeah.
So we're talking about 2 months.
Yeah.
And then, so I mean, if you want updates, and that's not going to happen if you get farm meetings. I mean.
Oh, yeah.
That's not what you're asking for.
No.
Well, let me ask this question, though. So every CWC, we've had a report and updates on the rolling and things. You, as a member, have an opportunity to ask questions. I think last time Natalie asked questions, is there any issue or problem that come up? So the opportunity is there for you to do that.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, well.
Yeah, we have, most definitely we've made it more transparent than when we first started.
That's fine with me.
Go ahead. Yeah.
What about being notified of project completions.
Say that again, Harry.
Well, are we going to be
that would be part of the presentation, right?
Is it? Well, okay.
So
I didn't know what people were going to be here and making these presentations on a routine basis.
Specifically in regards to issues.
So if I wanted just to recall.
Construction issues, delays.
Now, I'm not sure if you were here yet. Maybe you were. Last summer there was a meeting. I didn't attend. I think it was. I was somewhere. Dennis helped. You created the agenda, and there was a lot on the agenda. After that meeting, there was a discussion of streamlining, but making sure with the constant things that were going to be there, were going to be a presentation of the CM or the architect on projects. So I think since then we've complied to the request that you guys wanted.
Yeah, I just started. Yeah, and every meeting we've had from.
Yes, so then we've done that. So we've been committed to what you guys want.
Okay. So can I get some help on this sentence?
Which one?
Right here. The agendas for the regularly scheduled meetings were amended to include monthly updates related to construction issues, budget. How was it changed? And is this important?
Project completion.
Meetings were amended. How were they amended? When were they amended?
Right before Matt came. Now we get updates all the time from the construction managers.
You also get financial information, correct?
Yeah. Correct.
That's true.
That's to provide greater transparency and information to CBOC and the public?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
That work for you?
That's fine.
So that's your starting paragraph. And then getting back down to the recommendations, where I think we jumped off. We talked about these here. And then Harry had asked for some information to be added. And I think, Harry, this was what you were looking for? Is that the correct paragraph that I pulled from your
deck? Yeah. We'll have to discuss that in the future. But yeah. Let's say,
okay.
My recommendation, other people may not agree with it.
How do you feel? Where
is it?
How's everyone feel about
this?
This is part of the recommendation section.
It's hard to blast and turn it around.
To do an effective and efficiency audit and have a better understanding of what the current audits that they're doing are. Thank you. Okay.
Does this capture what the committee is looking for?
Yes.
Then I heard provide CBOC members all materials for the regularly held meetings one week prior to the meeting.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And what materials specifically are you looking to have posted on the website?
District produced specifically, vendor produced is available. Oh, sorry, I was on the wrong sentence.
Yeah.
Following meetings
following
is what
meetings.
I think I heard.
Yes.
Yeah,
right.
Part of my thought was just, besides it was good information for us to have, is just district transparency.
Looking back at the purpose of the annual report, since I'm a complete novice on your committee, have you reported out the couple things that you need to report out?
No.
Okay.
Well, yes, but I think it needs to be said again because currently they are not in compliance.
That's the biggest.
Correct. And that we have witnessed that bond funds have only gone to
well, the finer conclusion, is that conclusion?
Yeah, that would be.
The conclusion?
And do we need to go into the to that article to know what that article is to say that we're in compliance?
What is it? Article 8, sub CB.
And you're saying we're not?
We are not. At this time, at the time of presenting, we will not be in compliance. But at the time of the next presenting, we will be. Well, we're not in compliance.
Well, actually, the compliance, can you scroll all the way back up, Dennis, please? Do you need to look at that? Do we need to open up and read the article? Article 8A,
Section 1B3 of the California Constitution is pretty much stating, and we can bring it up if we need to, that we attest and know that none of these bond funds, we've seen them being used for approved bond projects, and it's not being used to pay teacher administration salaries.
So are we in compliance then?
That we are in compliance with that.
Yes.
I don't know that.
Everything they presented to us and everything we've asked for has come to the conclusion that they are currently
along
in compliance.
Along with the audits.
Yes.
Now, the only thing, are we asking, if maybe I think what we're getting to, Harry, is are we asking the wrong questions? Is that what you're, I mean, are there more questions we need to ask?
Let me ask you
don't
this.
Feel...
Go ahead.
Harry, would look at the screen up here, because what I heard said was this, and I think, Nat, you're asking, should this statement be based on the information shared with the CBOC? We believe.
Yes.
Would that address your concern, Harry?
Say
for
that
information
again.
Provided.
Okay. Say that again.
Let me type it up here.
CBOC.
That's better. Now, and that's very good. That's how, and I heard somebody mention it based on what information, and they wanted, one of them was the audit. Is that
the
correct?
The audit?
Pardon?
No. Didn't find that any bond money was going to administration.
Okay. Yeah, I was just asking the question if that's what you're basing it on. Okay. Because I would like to read. Part of my recommendations was to have an account. Another, had to go back up to where it was for the a different kind of audit. California.
You put it in there.
California League of Bond Oversight Committee. Currently, the performance audits are of very limited value to the CBOC. On what was done and how well it was done. The CBOC can't fulfill its mission without this information. So, basically, it's saying that the performance audits are not of a lot of value. Let me find the right words. They're ineffective at producing any useful information that a committee can use to determine whether or not the district is in performance. They really don't produce good information in that respect. So, just so I can understand,
what do you feel is different between the two audits that would make it more beneficial for you?
Is that
a conversation
to
the end of the year report, or is that a conversation?
Well, if it's a recommendation, if you guys are recommending to do that, do you know what the cost of it is, too, so you can put that in there also?
I know it's an expensive.
Is it something we really haven't
Whatever, I don't care.
We need to go, I think that's something we need to put on agenda and
how about looking into the effectiveness?
What's that?
Well,
you already have something on there with the recommendations, but I think I'm just kidding. Maybe we should put that up on our next meeting and put it in the agenda.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes, because
this is not the time to be debating. You know how much it's going to cost or what's in it. What is,
so to get Harry's input, what the recommendation is the. It's recommended, you can make recommendations for you as CBOC members, right? So the CBOC recommends that they will look into different types of audits that are available to CBOCs? I mean, because the recommendation is I mean... So these are kind of recommendations like, for you, right? As CBOC members?
No, this is recommended. Well, for
us and
for
the board.
For the board.
For the board.
This is what we're recommending to the board.
This is the community, isn't it? I'm getting confused now. I thought this was going to be for the community, not the board.
They do have to report to the board whether or not they are in conformance. That is a requirement. So, that is part of this.
Okay.
Report. We want to catch all the recommendations to recommend everything.
Because, what I'm trying to say with the recommendations is, I mean, it's a recommendation also for you as board, as CBOC members. So, there's a recommendation that the CBOC will pursue and look at different audits that are available.
I think we already covered that in one of the paragraphs. I don't know why we're talking about it anymore.
So you brought it up this reason.
No, people just started asking questions or something.
Actually, the first paragraph should not be a recommendation. We can approve the board.
But we're recommending to the board that they do.
You mentioned that already in our activity.
I think what might be difficult is that if you look at the bylaws of what the annual report, it's did we comply and then some activities. There is never a section for recommendations. So you see what I'm saying? It's
instead of this will provide
maybe that's why
it doesn't
fit
upon approval.
Yes.
So we don't need that.
Did you hear what I said?
No.
And maybe the reason why the recommendations are awkward is because in the bylaws it says there's basically two things. Did we comply? And what are activities? Do you usually put in a report what you are going to do as a CBOC to improve? See, that's why maybe it's awkward. Because part of it is saying, what are recommendations? But if you go back to the recommendations, Dennis.
I was working on this.
I appreciate it.
I like it.
Is that better for folks?
Instead of saying this whole.
In the bottom.
Okay. Yeah.
And then you can remove the bottom thing.
What, remove it? I mean, it's.
Well, what I'm trying to say with the recommendations is that if you go back to the original thing of the bylaw that says, do we comply and what are activities, there isn't a recommendation piece in that. Because recommendations are for yourselves.
I do understand that,
but
we're a little cut above.
That's fine. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at what the two things that you have to do are, according to your bylaws. That's what your report's supposed to be on.
Yeah.
Right.
Because
I don't know whether there's more. That's what.
So I guess the question I'm asking, those recommendations are for what audience? Because this is a report to the public. Is this a recommendation of what the CBOC is recommending that they will do differently next year? So will the CPC?
I think it addresses everything.
That's fine. So I just think.
I mean, because the recommendation is a recommendation, whether it's for the board to make a recommendation for us, something we want to see, something we want to do, something, it's there for improvement. So I think we captured that.
Okay. Should the conclusion be the last thing, not the recommendations? Because the conclusion is the final gist of what
is conclusion means.
And yeah. Do you want to print it so you guys can read it? Mm-hmm. So we sent it to me.
I'm glad I'm gonna send it.
And I just, again, throughout the whole document, this is the role of the school district bond, in case, not the, I think there was some role in Heights in there. It just,
yeah, we actually took out
the. You guys took it.
Wait a minute. I thought, just a little while ago, you said the district is not in front of goals because of not having the seven members. And even the committee was not in conformance last year.
This is important.
Because
so you're saying in the conclusion portion of it, you would like to add that
we weren't in compliance with the.
With having seven members.
We are currently not in compliance.
But after June 13, we're compliant.
Well, can we look at Article 13A?
He's saying that we're not compliant to Ed Code, but the one thing that the bond oversight needs to be is we need to be in compliance of Title 8, which we are.
He's saying Ed Code 15278.
Which
we're not in compliance of.
True. So
we can put that.
Do we want to say currently we're not in compliance? But we will be after.
Well,
that's the same board meeting that we took over because we work.
This is a report for the last year. Not this year. Currently.
Until June 30th.
So June 30th.
Yeah. So that means we are. Still have two vacancies, but until June 13th, we're filling.
Would it be helpful to put up the article to see what the article? I don't. Does the article state seven? See, because it's
no article 8 is all about administration. Yeah.
Is that final mention?
And that we're
up to seven or have to be seven?
It's 8. A subsection.
And. Do you want us to, why don't?
Well, we're in compliance of the
state constitution.
State, yeah.
Although we were found,
you
although we were
not the educational code.
How do you know that?
Because no questions that I've asked, no document that
anything
we asked for.
Everything that's been presented to us has been in compliance.
Well, maybe the answer would be
everything that we've asked for has been given to us. Everything we've questioned has been answered. Everything we've doubted has been proven. Like I said, maybe the right questions weren't asked for learning points on our next go around this year. But everything that we have gotten so far, I haven't found anything at fault.
I've got any errors.
Errors in like what?
Reports
a new,
have you?
An yeah. Error.
I have.
And why haven't you brought them up?
I haven't seen. Yeah, they haven't been presented to us in our roundtable here.
Your name.
I mean, if you find errors, you need
to
bring them to us.
But I haven't seen any misuse of the.
Maybe
of
you guys should go around to find out if you guys all what you feel, because it's something that the group is saying. So. Maybe you guys should go around. Do you feel you're compliant or not? Yes or no?
I mean,
okay, I think Harry mentioned, why don't we just put a conclusion that, you know, in the past, this report by 1 year, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in the past year, we still had two vacancies. until June 13, the board approval, we will.
No, but I don't know if the seven members is part of that article I'm trying to say.
Okay,
so I'm saying, although we're in compliance, then we do find that we...
There you go, that'll work a little bit.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying. I say, put that up to read it, but I think in your conclusion, you can say, although we're in compliance, the CBC was not compliant in having seven members throughout the year. Because that is true. And that was
we weren't compliant, even though we didn't find any wrongdoings.
I know. Let me try to get the audit that shows that it referenced that we didn't have seven members. Let me get that.
That's what you do, like last
year. Oh, I have a copy of the audit.
Oh, you?
Yeah.
Yeah, let me have one here too.
Okay.
Yeah, last year we had six.
Okay. Well, who was the other one? What was her name?
Carla. Yeah. What we lost was
Carla. Page 10, you know.
That's when you're right.
No.
Page 10?
Page 10.
Carla's
Moreno.
Never mind. No, he was on here a few times,
and
once he left, because he was the business owner, that's when we
were looking at this. But this is kind of, this is a tricky thing, too. Is this audit thing is for the previous year, not for this year, too?
Right.
Because it won't be until the next audit where it's going to be for this one. But this is a different. This is Ed Code 15282. That's not what you guys are saying we're compliant.
Right.
So yeah. I would hate for the committee to say that you guys are not in compliance when you are in compliance.
Yeah, but Harry was mentioning Ed Code 15278.
I know, but. Based upon what you're doing, is compliance on Article 8.
Eight.
So
that's only for the...
There's Article 8 right there.
Yeah. Oh, because that's what's in our bylaws.
That's
what's in our bylaws.
The County Official Office of Education for the construction, reconstruction, rehabilitation, or replacement of school facilities, including furnishing and equipment of school facilities, or the acquisition or lease of real property for school facilities approved by 55% of the voters in the district or county as appropriate, voting on the proposition on or after the effective date of the measure, adding this paragraph. The paragraph shall apply to only if only the positions approved by the voters resulting in the bond indebtedness include all of the following accountability requirements.
So, in the recommendation, maybe that's where you put.
They were specific.
In order to be.
In compliance with that code.
Yeah, because that you're compliant. If you go back to the recommendation, Dennis. Thank you for highlighting that. All the activities must be compliant. If you go back to the recommendations, and I think maybe that's where it fits in there. Go down. Maintain a full complement of members. In order to be compliant in education code, blah, 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 as the CBC was not in the 16-17 school year.
What's
that? It's in the page 10. Did I get it back to you?
Yes.
You probably know on top of your head, right? Ed Code 15282. 282?
And 8.
In order to be compliant, 15282.
What is it?
15278.
It's the one for the seven board members, the seven members.
15282.
15282.
8. As the district was not compliant in the 16-17 school year, or as not the district, as the CBOC was not compliant with in the 16-17 school year,
you can copy this words, you know.
Yeah, because that's in the audit. But, It's your report. You guys, whatever you guys want. People that want me to print it?
Yes.
Yeah. Majority? Okay, so
let me email it to you. We're gonna have to have somebody format it because for some reason it's not formatted properly.
He can format it.
What's that?
Did you send it?
I'll send it.
Is he at the
room? Did you save it?
Yes, I've saved it.
Oh my god, you just made my heart stop.
Oh.
So it went blank. I'm like, oh my gosh.
Okay.
I'm out of here.
And Mr. Peterson, you can share with the rest of the committee that the entire Brown Act presentation from last year is on my YouTube site. So you can see the entirety of it as presented here at the district.
Both.
so.
I think your brownies could seal the deal. I think that's it.
What's that? So nobody was interested in my story of pushing David out of the kitchen. they weren't flipping.
Holy shit.
There's a lot of politics involved, so the community will probably go through something, the board will probably get involved, and then I have to deal with the principals. So what I basically do is I take space away from the school, so that another school could call their co-located. So charter schools are co-located on district property. And there's a lot of
He's gonna tidy it up.
This is still wrong. Yeah. Yeah, never mind.
What is?
Never mind.
You might as well fix it.
Okay.
It's time. Yeah.
If you find something that's wrong, you need to let us know.
I can say
that. Here's what I would suggest. If there's a content error or a content clarification, let me know and I'll fix it.
Yeah.
If it's grammar, punctuation, layout, I'll have one of the secretaries polish that for you, if that's acceptable.
Yeah, I think he was having a content issue.
Yeah, never mind.
But I am happy to do whatever you'd like.
Okay.
video.
Yeah, no, I just was looking for how many meetings we've done for last year? You said that eight, and then you mentioned
we had eight, but only six went through because we didn't have a forum for it.
Do we mention? Do we need to mention how many? This is a dungeon, you know.
Three and six? Take out three.
No, the keep three.
Keep three.
You just want to keep three.
And give me.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm looking at it. Okay. Yes, 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 yes.
Page three.
So.
I was looking at the whole paragraph over here. Okay.
Can you see that?
That's
yeah.
Seven. That's paragraph seven.
Did you page three?
What is it you'd like me to look at?
Okay.
Kill paragraph seven.
We want to kill that right there, that last one.
This last one?
Yep.
Yeah. Yep.
All of it. Bye bye.
Done.
And also paragraph three.
Go up.
CBOC.
And
yeah.
Change the grammar on it.
Assess.
Right there. Member. It's rough.
Yeah. Change the member. And this last paragraph.
No. Right there. See after assist.
See
one says change the members.
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 Scroll up.
Yeah.
No, down, down, down.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to be an issue.
And this
one. Yeah. That's a long meeting. And Mikey, sent me a message. So just chill out. Don't let this.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, so. Yeah, oh, yeah, you got
Wendy. As co-chairman, is not here or doesn't do something the co-chairman is supposed to do it. Would you like to deliver the annual report?
Well, I think we work together, right?
No, one of the co-chairmen's doing it. You're the co-chairman. I'm asking if you'd like to deliver the report this year.
I can, but I think thing.
But I think she has a good suggestion. If you guys want to break it up and read it up in three different articles, three different ways, you guys can do that too.
We can present it together. Anybody available on that day?
I don't know. I'm seriously not.
That's fine. No, that's fine.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty sure it's good unity.
So we can have a better team. We can each one talk about one section.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, at least we show, we
Well, you have the activity, you have the introduction, then you have the activities, the recommendations, and the conclusion. Maybe the introduction, maybe the activities, and then you can close it up with the recommendations. Well, whatever you guys want, I'll go.
You're welcome to deliver the whole thing if you'd like. It's my time, sorry. But if you don't want to, you don't want to split it up, then that's fine. It's just,
are you not going to be here that night, Mr.?
No, that's not the problem. No.
Okay.
No.
So you'll you three will do it then? Harry?
Next Tuesday.
Mike, are you going to be available or?
Okay,
So the report was presented by Harry, Wendy, and Nellie.
Mm-hmm. That's all great.
Are we good with? Is everybody good with the way it looks?
Yes.
Any other directions? Wendy's like our heads on.
Well, I think the grammar they have too.
Yeah. There's grammar, spacing, and format. But
is
content wise, you're okay?
Content, verbatim, we're fine.
So it's going to be Carrie, Wendy, Nat, and Natalie that are going to present it?
No, that's.
And she's asking only because she's doing the minutes, not because she's trying to say we should do it.
When do you. Can you email us the final version?
Sure, you can.
We can have you.
We can get it on Monday.
Right,
Tuesday. Well, Tuesday I'm not here, so could you do that for me, then?
What do you mean you're not here on Tuesday? You are here on Tuesday. We have a.
Well, sorry.
On Tuesday.
Monday, I'm not here.
I'm not here on Monday.
Okay.
So we can send this to someone to.
How about we email to Josefina? Josefina can send it, clean it up, and send it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll email this back to you again. Kind of final.
Okay.
And then you can take it from there.
I keep it sent directly to us now. I know part of the
we're ready to close this meeting?
It does it with the chair.
That's what I'm speaking
with. Keep it grinding.
I will first.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Bye.
All right.
Bye.
That's it? No more? The lights are going down?
The meeting's at 7?
The board meeting is 7 o'clock for open session. Mm-hmm. Is there any recognition?
5 o'clock for
open session. There's a few recognitions. So that we put the hangar report early into the board meeting.
It was changed to 4:30.
4:30 for the recognition goes closed session and after.
Yeah.
So our this official meeting is closed. It's open. It's not official meeting. It's fine. Just want to make sure everyone knows.
So open meeting is
recorded.
So how do we? Do you
want
to discuss right now? Break down the report.
We can do it by email once we get it. So I'll be on the same email once. It'll just be easy to start a drive there.
So Sabina coming in tomorrow?
Just be careful that you don't violate any ground act.
Right.
Thank you so much, members.